Stokey is relatively new to me. I don't have a lot of information about it, but I can show you how it basically works. It is one of the highest prams on the market. When I say the highest prams, I mean that baby sits really close to you. So we'll start with adjusting the pram up and down. So there's a little, anything on this pram that's basically white, similar to a bugaboo, will do something, and that's what I've learnt myself. So there's a little clip here which will recline and sit up the seat. So you got 1, 2, 3 positions. You have these white buttons here which will take your seat off. But before taking the seat off, you have to take the footrest off. So at the back here, again, the white button to remove the footrest. Then the white buttons that are behind at the same time, take them off. And turn the seat around and you can place it back on. This has been so far the easiest pram to take off and put back on. I find it really easy, it lines up on its own so conveniently. To put the footrest back in, you have to press this button and slide it in. So it has a few settings, so it can be right up close and then it can come down. I think 1 or 2 settings. Yeah. 1, 2, 3. So you got 3 settings there. Belly bar's removable and it's really easy to do as well. So I like the convenience of how the items come off this pram. The buttons are just on there and they push in so easy. And you just put it back on. I also really, really, really like the harness and how it does up. So I will bring you in closer. It's a 5-point harness, but you only clip in the 2 pieces at a time. Like 2 pieces together at a time, like that, and that one there, and that's all in nicely. Another thing about this pram is that it has the insert in here for when the baby is younger or older. So when it's younger, you put this insert in. When it's older, you take it out, and it makes the seat deeper, more like a bucket seat. The hood is not the biggest hood that I have seen, but it's still decent, and it also has at the back the mesh, so this unzips and you have your mesh up here. The handle at the back is adjustable via the white button here, I think. Lift that one, no, wrong one, under here, yes. So you can have 1, 2, 3 settings, 4 settings, and then it also folds right over or right under to fold it up as well. So I've been told when I fold it down to fold it this way. Okay, so I love all of this about the Stokey. It has, it's really nice and easy to push. The seats face both ways. Using just in general all the clips and buttons that you press on the Stokey to change the seat, to take the seat off, are really easy and I like them. I've never even put the capsule on, but here are the capsule adapters. I'll also get out a few other bits that come with it. Has a nice little drink holder that slips on up the back. So what I'll do is this one. Yes, this brings your hand down. So even if you had a tiny daughter or son that wanted to push the pram, they actually can, which is awesome. You can see the cup holder here, it has a little slot on the back and that literally just slips right into there. There's your cup holder. And you can still adjust the handle underneath that. Take it off, you just slip it up. I've been told to not fold it on with the cup holder. So to put the capsule on, you need to, take the pram off, so the 2 buttons at the back lift it up, and I'll pop that over here, and that doesn't really sit, I don't like that, yeah, okay, well the seat doesn't sit very well, so I'll just put it up here, and you have 2 adapters that will go on. If I can figure that out. So this way and this way. Okay, that seems easy. And then the caption goes on facing you, of course. One, two, and click it in. So the tether's just hanging off the back. So I'll just pop that up in here for now. So there's your caption on your prim. It's super high. Look how close Bub is to you. Right here. I don't have to bend over or anything. Bub is right here at my level. I mean, if you were taller or shorter, it would depend, but for me, that's an awesome height. Alright, so pardon me, there's that. So I'll take the capsule off. So you do that, handle back up, and then it's the normal way to get a max cozy off. So the two grey buttons up here, squeeze and lift. And I've been told that it will fold up with the adapters on. I'm not going to do it for this sake, but I believe that you can. I've been told that you can. Why is that not coming off?
Oh, because it's a push-in, not a...
Okay. Again, easy buttons to remove the items. The bag, yes, that's what we're missing, is the storage underneath. This big bag on the front can unattach, so it just has a little strap around the back. So if you put all your stuff in there, you could basically use that as your nappy bag and then attach it to the front of your crib, which is amazing. And you're just left with this little platform down here. So that's got a bag strap on it, and this is the strap that holds it to the pram. And I'm just going to put that back on. Okay, so let's get to folding the pram. I'm going to try and remember how to do this. So I'm going to put the brake on for my convenience. The next thing that we do is you want to push this down and, well, maybe not. How about we make them the handle and then we'll push this around to here. And then the next thing is there's two buttons under here. So one for your thumb and one for your pointer finger and index finger, I guess. And we need to push them together at the same time. So one's forward and one's up. And then you also have to press this down here with your foot. Hey, I did it. This is the first time I put this in my car. Why is it not looking? I put this in my car and couldn't figure it out. Oh, there we go. And I struggled and struggled, and the lady helped me. But I figured it out. So that's your fold. That's an 8. It's huge. That is way too big as a pram to be folded. I don't know, it's up to you guys, but me personally, not ideal. And I mean, if this was out, look how much longer. Oops, wrong one, this one. It's down. Look how much longer again it is. Yeah, so anyways, to put it back up, let's see how I do that. Put it up, press the two buttons together, and it should, when I push them hard enough. I felt it go that time. Oh, there we go. And walk it back out. And then adjust the height of the handle. Take the brake off so I can move it. And put the seat back on. I literally didn't line that up. I just pushed it forward and it lines up itself. It's amazing. I like that it's nice and easy to push. Yeah, it's awesome to push. I'm not a fan of the fold and how big it is. Although doing that's my second time that I've done it, and I feel like a lot better with it already.
One more thing, I was sure it did it, but I wasn't entirely sure. This here is a little white flick switch again, so it's up really quite high. Oh, and then it's down. Lower, so it clicks on when you are finished like that and undoes. So I'm gonna put it up high. Oh, you can't really see the indents, they go all the way down, all the way up. So I put it at the highest setting, I'm gonna click it in to place, and I'll show you that. Made a new liner. for this pram, and it has the chevron on the other side, which I'll show you. This is the other liner. It has a little bit of purple throughout, mostly boyish colours. It's very cute.
Yeah, I really like this pram. Maybe it will grow on me. I like some features of it, but not everything about it. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video.